watch the videos 8 to 3 days before the exam takes place. So what we try to do is we always give them little bits during the semester where you have to put in the work in order to get extra credit so that you'll do better on your test. So you can change your final grades up to, I think, 10-15% to the positive. And people tend to try to do that. And what we do, we take e-assessments in our PC halls. You see one of the bigger PC halls, again, something that we learned from Delft and try to copy. But then what we did a couple years ago, we were asked by edX to be one of the German partners for the edX platform. And we said, okay, we've been doing flipped classroom modes videos for a long term now. We feel that we're ready to go on a different MOOC platform to go on edX. We're one of the contributing chartered members, like to Delft is, for edX. And then basically Kiron came along. And I think we were one of the first contacts. Vincent contacted our vice president, who was sitting next to me in the next office, and he came and was like, okay, this sounds like a good idea, should we do something like that? And we said, well, yeah, of course we should help the refugees, just like Anya said, if they're trying to get into our higher education in Germany, why don't we take our courses, the flipped classroom courses that we have, and give them out? Because what we found out is the first idea was, okay, there are so many MOOCs out there on so many topics. Normally, we don't care how you learn as long as you pass the exam. So the first idea was, okay, let's just give them some MIT MOOCs or something, and then give them the exam, and if they pass in the end, this is fine. So we asked our teachers to look into those courses. It's like, do those courses fit for what you want to teach? Or what you want to have taught in order to pass your exams. And our lecturers are, okay, these are MIT courses. They have to be at least our standard. They have to be even higher. But then they started looking into the courses and into the exams. That wasn't a good idea. So basically everybody said, was like, okay, these are not comparable courses on to what we do on campus. These are more like teasers for what we do. And this was the start for our idea to say, okay, why don't we just take our courses? We have the edX platform. edX allowed us to put them on the platform, but not like on the open edX platform, because we weren't really happy with some of the videos that we produced. These were like early day videos. We didn't want to put German-speaking MOOCs out into the world that we didn't feel had like, yeah, they weren't like the types that we wanted to show off. By that time, we only had like a couple MOOCs online that were highly produced, that we were using for marketing for our university, stuff like that. So edX allowed us to put up those videos only for our students and for Kiron students. So we don't have that high numbers that Anya has had in our courses. But what we did is we put out four MOOCs within a couple of weeks, actually, from that decision. Okay, we want to help Kiron. We signed an agreement, and then we put up the MOOCs on edX. Only took us a couple of weeks. So we took Introduction into Business Administration, Marketing, Mechanics, and Thermodynamics. Yes?
Just to go back to that, was it just production values the reason why they didn't want you to put it on the Open edX platform?
No, this was our decision.
Well, that you didn't want to do it.
Yes.
And
yes.
It wasn't good.
Yeah.
It's fine for teaching.
Yeah.
It just wasn't good.
Yeah.
Fine.
Yeah, they were, by that time, it was like, okay, we decided to be edX partner. We were like the second university behind TU Munich, to go onto that platform. We had a big market outreach with our first MOOCs. We had a couple of 10,000 enrollments into those courses. That was like our target group by that time. By now, we feel free, and we're about to open up those courses, at least for the German speaking